Hello and welcome to another video. In this video, we will have a look at the LilyGo ESP32 board, which has a 4.7-inch e-paper display. I created two small applications with it, a YouTube subscriber counter and a simple quote slideshow app. And in this video, I'll give you my thoughts on this board. This video is not sponsored, and I paid for all the boards I'm showing you with my own money. Let's get started. First of all, what is this board? This board is an ESP32 board with a big 4.7-inch e-paper display attached to it. So we have a very powerful processor to work with and a very big e-paper display at the same board. Also, this board offers a battery charging circuit and an 18650 battery holder. There is also another version of the board which does not offer a battery holder but a LiPo battery connector instead. Guess what? I bought both of them. Let's now take a look at the heart of the board, the ESP32 chip. I created a simple table in order to be easier to see the most important features of this chip. It offers two 32-bit processing units operating at 240 MHz. The chip also offers Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity, 8 MB of PSRAM memory and 16 MB of flash memory. The display this board uses is a 4.7-inch e-ink display with a resolution of 960 by 540 pixels. It supports 16 gray levels and partial refresh. The display also supports an add-on touchscreen module, which I don't have to test it so far. The board also offers 5 buttons. 4 of them are programmable and 1 is the reset button. Additionally, we have a few GPIO pins left at these 3 4-pin connectors. Lastly, the board offers a USB Type-C connector to program the board, charge the battery and power the board when no battery is inserted. Cool! This board can be programmed using the Arduino IDE and with MicroPython. I only tested this on Arduino, so I don't know how well MicroPython works with it. The company that creates this board claims that it can achieve 170 milliamps of deep sleep current, which is very cool if true. The price of this board at the time of this recording is about $40, which in my opinion is not high, considering that a big e-paper display can cost as much. Enough with the specs, let's build something. First of all, we have to configure the Arduino IDE to use this board. In order to use it with Arduino, you must have the package for the ESP32 boards installed. If not, there are many videos online that show you how to do it. Next, you are going to need to download a library for this board. Visit the GitHub page of the board, download the library, give it a proper name without special characters, and unzip it in the Arduino libraries folder. Now we are ready to use it. Let's load an example from the libraries folder. We go to File, Examples, LilyGo EPD47, and we select the demo sketch. Now, before we upload the sketch, we have to go to Tools, Boards, Manager, and select the ESP Dev board. Then we have to enable the PSRAM by clicking here. Now we are ready to press Upload. After a few seconds, the sketch is uploaded and you can see it running. Cool. As you can see, the demo sketch is using the partial refresh feature, which updates only part of the display to display the voltage on a certain pin. It works. I have also built two simple projects with this board so far. The first one is a YouTube subscriber counter for my new YouTube channel named Programming with Nick. You can think of this new channel as a complementary channel to this one. The new channel is going to have programming tutorials and courses, things that are not hardware related, and this one is going to have hardware related stuff just like it always had. I will put a link to it in the video description. If you are interested in programming, check it out. It will help you learn a lot of new things. The second small project I built with this board is a simple quotes slideshow app. As you can see, it just displays some images every few seconds. The e-paper display is quite fast and it looks cool. It looks even better in person. I will provide a link to the source code of both projects in the video description in case you want to experiment with it. Now, let me share with you my honest opinion about this board. I like it. It has everything we need. A powerful processor, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, a lot of RAM, very low power consumption, a battery holder and charger, and of course a big, fast e-ink display. In theory, this is a great all-in-one development board. The only problem I experienced with the board so far is that sometimes the display does not clear completely when updating its content. The contents displayed before clearing are sometimes slightly visible. I don't know what causes it nor how to solve it. Maybe it is a driver's issue, or maybe I'm not using the library correctly. Other than that, an experienced maker can build impressive things with a board like this. A beginner will give up after a few hours. The most important disadvantage of this board is the lack of documentation and the library support. I can't understand how such a great board can have such a poor documentation, which is literally non-existent. The engineers who developed this board spent weeks or months to create and test the hardware of this board, maybe a week to write the Arduino library, an hour to write the documentation, and 10 minutes to promote this board. It is a pity. If the library was better and the documentation was better, this board could become a huge success. At its current state, I don't recommend it to new Arduino users. You can buy this board if you are a beginner and only want to run projects that other people have made for it. This board can perform marvels if you know sophisticated C programming and have hours available to tinker with it to figure out how things work. Otherwise, you should search elsewhere. There are many more user-friendly boards out there. I hope you like this video. I will try to build a more advanced project with this board in the near future. Share me your project ideas in the comment section below, and maybe I can build something from your ideas. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.